What's up everyone, it's Kenji here, and in this video I thought I'd share how to become faster on Excel using the quick access toolbar. And you can download the file I'll be working with down in the description, so let's get into it. And you might be wondering, what's wrong with using regular keyboard shortcuts? Well, sometimes they're hard to reach and they require you to memorize a lot of keystrokes. That's when the quick access toolbar comes handy. For example, let's say we work on a business selling Apple products, and each week we get a dataset like this one from the warehouse team, where we have the revenue breakdown per week over here. And so we have the total revenue, then we have the quantity sold, as well as the average sale price for each product. And our goal is basically to reformat this to look like this one over here, such that we can send it to the senior management team later on. For this, we might be tempted to just use the regular keyboard shortcuts, so let's go ahead and do that. So over here, go to control page down. On the top part, we're gonna need it in dark blue. So go to Alt H H. From there, we're gonna select the dark blue color over here. Then Alt H F C, that's gonna be for the font color, change that to white. Then we can auto fit this column width for column B, just make it wider basically. So go to control space and then Alt H O I. We also wanna remove all of these grid lines. As you can see, we don't have them over here. So go to Alt W V G for that. As you can probably start to tell, that's quite a lot of different keystrokes that you need to memorize, and sometimes it takes 4 steps just to make one action. So if you're feeling a bit lazy about this and you're not bothered to memorize all of these different keystrokes, that's when the quick access toolbar can come handy. By default, you should be able to find the quick access toolbar right over here on the top hand side of your Excel file. That being said, yours might look slightly different to mine, as mine's already personalized and yours is probably not quite yet. Now to quickly show you what it does, go to control page down over here to this unformatted sheet. And if you recall, firstly we had to autofit the column width over here. So for that, before we had to do the Alt HOI, whilst now we can just do the Alt 5, that's gonna do the same thing for us in 2 strokes instead of 4. Similarly, we had to remove all of these grid lines over here if you recall. For that we had to do Alt WVG, whilst now we can just do the Alt 8 and we get the same feature done in half the amount of time, right? Now that's just a few quick examples of what the quick access toolbar can do for you, but there's dozens of different features in there, which we'll get into now. For this, go to Alt FT, which is just file options. From there, we wanna go to the quick access toolbar. And over here on the left-hand side, you're gonna have all of the different things that you can put into the quick access toolbar, while on the right are currently the things that you have in there. And probably if you haven't touched this before, you're just gonna have options like save or undo, things like that. Generally speaking, you don't really want the ones that are very easy. So for instance, for saving, it's just Control S. For undoing, it's just Control Z. So these are really simple features that don't really make much sense to have in there, because that would basically take the same amount of time to just press Control S as it would to access it from the quick access toolbar. So instead, what you want to put in here are things that are a bit harder to find and that usually require quite a lot of different keystrokes. Also, you want them to be features that you use fairly often. There's no point having the most obscure formula in there under quick access, right? Feel free to copy what I currently have if you feel like those are gonna be useful to you. So here I've got 2 different pasting formats. Then I've got the shortcut for borders, for merging and centering, for column width, for the fill and the font color, grid lines, and lastly the camera, which we'll talk about later. If you're unable to find the ones over here under the default tab, you can go ahead and go under each of the different tabs that you have on Excel typically, say under the home tab for example, and look for the one that you want from there. Then you just want to press the add button to import it over here and then hit OK. There is another, perhaps a bit more convenient way of inputting things into the quick access toolbar. So for example, let's say I like this wrap text feature and I use it a lot, I can just go to right click. And from there I can go to add to quick access toolbar, which is probably an easier way for you to find what you use most often. Now that we understand what the quick access toolbar is and how to personalize it, let's go ahead and work on this dataset over here to try to make it look like this one. Before we continue, I want to talk about Financial Edge and their new platform, Felix. Felix is an on-demand toolkit for people pursuing a career in finance or business. Using the platform, you can expand your knowledge with instructor-led videos on anything from interviewing to investing. For example, let's say you want to learn more about ESG, which seems to be the latest buzzword in business. For that, you can just go to the platform and look it up, and there you'll get a playlist of videos on the topic, ranging from what it is to how it's measured and how to invest in it. Furthermore, if you're unsure about something or you want to learn more about the topic, you can always ask an instructor with industry experience about it to get a personalized response. Felix also offers a company analysis tool, where you can look up any company. So for example, let's say I type Apple in here, and you can get their most relevant data ranging from their summarized financials to their competition in this simple layout that's easy and convenient for you to understand. So if you're interested, check out the link in the description below where you can get 25% off using code KENJIFELIX. All right, back to the video. Now that we've set up the quick access toolbar, let's go ahead and use it. And to activate it, you press the Alt key, and here you'll start to find all of the different shortcuts that are gonna be available. Press the Escape key to get out of that, and the idea is to essentially make it look like this formatted sheet over here. So first things first, let's remove the grid lines. For that, we can just press the Alt 8. Then we're gonna autofit this column width, so go to Control Space, and then press the Alt 5 key. That's gonna autofit it for us. Then let's select this area over here, so Shift down, Shift right arrow, and we want to press the Alt 6, and we're gonna select the blue fill over here. Then the font color, we wanna make that one white, so go to Alt 7, and from there we're gonna select the white one. Control B is gonna bolden it for us. Then just below the revenue one here, we want it in light blue, so go to Alt 6, and we'll select the light blue, which is gonna be this top one over here. Control B to bolden as well. Then just over here towards the bottom side, on this area here, so go ahead and press the Control B to bolden. Then we're gonna put a top border. So for that, go to Alt 3, and from there you'll press the P key, which is gonna be the top border for us. Then let's reformat these figures here so they look a bit better. Go to Control 1 key. From there, you're gonna wanna go under the number. So go ahead and click that. We don't want any decimals, they're not really necessary. Use the comma separator, and let's select this third one over here, press OK. Then we want to merge and center this top part over here, so the title. For that, we can just press the Alt 4, that's gonna do it for us. Now that we're happy with the first table format, we can just go ahead and copy that to the across the other tables as well. So Shift right arrow, Shift down arrow there, Control C, and from there, if you just paste it normally by pressing Control V, you're actually gonna wipe out all of the numbers that were there before and just copy the same ones, which is not quite what we want. Instead, we just wanna paste the format. So for that, press Control Z first, and what you can either do, the typical shortcut here is the Alt H V R, which is quite a tedious process, so press Control Z. The other one you can do is do Control Alt V, and from there you would just paste the formats over here. Press the Escape key to get out of that. But using the quick access toolbar, all we gotta do is go to Alt 2, and we'll get the same thing done in just two steps. Same thing down over here, so let's go ahead and select the area, and then go to Alt 2. Control up to go all the way to the top, and as you can see, now it's looking pretty similar to the other one. Now this whole process maybe took about half the keystrokes that it would have if we just used the traditional shortcuts. That's just doing it once. If you have to do this every week, it can essentially save you hours and hours of time. And if you're wondering what this camera icon over here that I have under quick access toolbar does, it's not to take selfies on Excel, but it's actually to screenshot. So let's say we want this area over here, we can go ahead and select it, and then we're just gonna press the Alt 9 key. From there, let's say we wanna paste it over here. Now, as you can see, it's a screenshot, and you're probably wondering, well, what's the difference between this and any other screenshot using any software? And the difference is that with this one, it's dynamic. So for example, let's say I change this figure to A5, and you can see that the table over here has actually changed, even though it's behaving exactly like an image. So that's what's nice about it, that it's fully dynamic. Overall, you can change the location of the quick access toolbar up over here, and then you can go to show below the ribbon, which is gonna be down over here in this area, if that's a bit better for you. For me, I find it a bit annoying as it occupies a bit of this space here. So just bring it back up by going to show above the ribbon. As you get more familiar with the quick access toolbar, feel free to personalize it in a way that you have the features that you use more regularly up there on top. For more on Excel, you can check out this link over here, or you can also look at this video over here on Excel formulas, or this other video over here on PowerPoint shortcuts, which are also somewhat similar to the Excel ones. That's all for this video. Hit that like, hit that subscribe if you liked it, and I'll catch you in the next one.